At Google, we recognize the importance of how AI is developed and used. So in 2018, we shared the AI principles that guide our work in research. As the product manager for the bioacoustics team at Google, I relied on these AI principles to help my team open source a machine learning model that can detect marine mammals and that could be socially beneficial, built and tested for safety while upholding high standards of scientific excellence for the marine biologists and researchers worldwide. Back in 2019, we partnered up with the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, also known as NOAA, to train a machine learning model that could automatically detect humpback whale calls given an audio recording. Knowing where the whales are at a point in time can enable researchers to understand their migration patterns, where they feed, and where to place protected areas to successfully protect these whales. The following year, we worked with the Department of Fisheries and Ocean in Canada on a similar project, but this time to automatically detect the presence of southern resident killer whales, which is a critically endangered subspecies of orcas, in the Vancouver Harbor. We realized that actually many other researchers could use the same technology for important research. For example, better understanding the oceans or mapping ecosystems or protecting key biodiversity areas. So what we did is we turned to our AI principles and submitted an AI principle review request. We were struggling with a dilemma within our team. On the one hand, we knew our model could be helpful to ocean scientists who wish to analyze sound files, and we knew that we had the ability to continue to improve this model to encompass more species than just humpback whales and orcas. On the other hand, we were worried that poachers might track down and hunt humpback whales or other marine mammals based on the insights provided by our technology. What if somehow bad actors use our model in ways we didn't intend? We wanted to do the right thing. We wanted a consultation with experts in the field in order to help us responsibly open source this technology while mitigating potential harms and amplifying social benefit. The process was thorough and meticulous. One of the reviewers on the Responsible Innovation team reached back out to me to explain the process and provide our team with a list of questions and next steps. Some of these questions included: would open sourcing this technology be socially beneficial? With this model, how are we and our technology accountable to people? How is this machine learning model built and tested for safety? After consulting with the AI principles team and discussing this question with third-party experts, it became clear that this risk was actually quite low for a variety of reasons, including how poachers and potential bad actors don't typically rely on machine learning technology. Furthermore, they would probably not be able to use these models due to the scientific complexity and data expertise that is required. So after significant deliberation and consultation, the experts in the field felt that the benefits outweighed the risks, so we chose to go forward and open source. In evaluating our idea to open source this model, Google wanted us to be accountable to people. The questions the AI principles reviewers asked actually helped us improve the usability and explainability of our model. They advised us to release instructions when we open source the model to offer user-friendly explanations to scientists. Once we received guidance and approval from the AI principal experts, we knew we could open source our model to the scientific community. We value reviews at any step in our research process, and it was great to have the support of experts from the AI principal review team. An AI ethics review is definitely an important process to complete, especially if you're going to open source technology.